ating abuti ng pangarap iwan sa pamamagitan ng naghahangad ang kaunlaran ay makakamta.
Okay, good morning. Gandang araw po sa lahat. Ako po si Aleli Plete from the Regional Cooperation and Training Section ng Technological Service Division ng DOST-ITDI. So, I'm your moderator for today and I would like to welcome everyone to our livelihood webinar series. And our topic for today is liquid hand soap or hand wash production. So, I think this topic is one of the most awaited webinar, I should say, by our clients because this is one of the very in-demand products during this time of pandemic. So, in fact, along with alcohol, hand sanitizer, face mask, face shields, ito halos walang makita po na produkto sa ating market. And according to reports also, the pandemic has brought people to become more aware of their personal hygiene, health, and safety. So the industry is anticipated to have an increase not only in the Philippines, but globally. So baka po ito yung business na pwede nyong simulan this year. Kaya hopefully talagang makapag-establish kayo po ng isang enterprise with this liquid hand soap production. So today, our resource speakers will discuss the ingredients, components, and functions of these ingredients, then step-by-step procedure to come up with the desired product. Likewise, a simple business opportunity plan will be presented by our experts to give you an idea of those who would like to start a business on liquid hand soap. So, a few reminders lang po. So, you have to check your audio and internet connection of your devices. So, siguro to have a smooth flow ng ating session na to, you can find a location kung saan po maganda yung ating signal para po walang interruption. And then, you can use the chat box for our for your questions po. And our speakers will answer all your questions after the presentation. Okay. So, before we start our webinar, let me introduce our agency. So, ITDI, or so-called Industrial Technology Development Institute, is a research and development agency under the Department of Science and Technology. Under the leadership of Dr. Annabel V. Briones, and our agency is located within the DOST compound in Bicutan, Taguig City. At para po makilala nyo pa ng lubos ang aming ahensya, we have a short AVP to present para po makita nyo yung aming programs and services that we offer to our clients and cater to the needs of various industries, including academe, LGUs, NGOs, associations, private sector, and other government agencies. So, let's see and watch our video.
We uplift lives through science, technology, and innovation. We contribute in making local industries globally competitive. We are the Industrial Technology Development Institute, one of the foremost research and development institutes of the Department of Science and Technology, or DOST. To accomplish all these, we focus on our three major functions: research and development, technical services, and technology transfer. ITDI leads the way in multidisciplinary industrial R&D. Our humble beginnings can be traced back to the Bureau of Government Laboratories, established on July 1, 1901 during the American regime, later renamed into the Bureau of Science in 1905. With studies focusing heavily on public health as needed by the times, scientists developed tiki-tiki from rice bran to combat beriberi, After several changes in names, the BS in 1958 became the National Institute of Science and Technology. At NIST, industrial R&D started gaining ground, harnessing local resources and skills towards self-sufficiency and optimized productivity. Finally, in 1987, NIST transformed Fulgear into an industrial R&D institute and was aptly named Industrial Technology Development Institute, or ITDI. ITDI R&D now focuses on five major areas, all aimed at supporting and answering the needs of concerned industries. Food processing. We conduct R&D for the effective usage of local food materials and resources, and upgrade the quality of local food products and productivity of the food industry. Material science. We conduct R&D to develop materials essential to local industries and for industrial purposes using locally available resources. Chemicals and energy. We conduct R&D studies on the production of organic, inorganic, and pharmaceutical chemicals and substances and energy technologies systems from indigenous raw materials for industrial applications. Environment and biotechnology. R&D focuses on environmental concerns and specializes in applied microbiology. We develop ways and means to manage domestic and industrial wastes generated from various sources. Packaging technology. We strive to make local industries and their products globally competitive through world-class, innovative, and sustainable packaging technology. Aside from R&D, ITDI also provides technical services to help make local industries meet global standards, improve their productivity, and make them ready to compete in the international arena. These are carried out through tests and analyses of various products and processes, metrology services, and knowledge translation or technology transfer and commercialization initiatives. ITDI's national laboratories that are equipped with state-of-the-art equipment and ISO-accredited take the lead in providing the technical services needed by industry. Its National Metrology Laboratory, or NML, establishes and maintains the national measurement standards for physical quantities such as mass, temperature, pressure, voltage, resistance, luminous intensity, and time interval, and their dissemination to Filipino users, ensuring that these are accurate and internationally traceable. While tests and analysis and performance testing of various products and materials are provided by its standards and testing division, using current or updated methods and instruments. Its rubber testing facility has been upgraded by acquiring state-of-the-art testing equipment to enable it to offer complete testing services for manufactured rubber and be aligned with ASEAN integration. STD is also one of the pillars of One Lab, an IT-based referral system wherein the services of participating laboratories are integrated to hasten and broaden public access to testing services of laboratories nationwide in one click. Meanwhile, ADMATEL, or Advanced Device and Materials Testing Laboratory, is the country's most advanced failure analysis and materials characterization testing facility, enabling local industries to have their products tested locally, ensuring faster turnaround time and savings. In addition, ITDI's NanoLab provides nanotechnology-related technical services and R&D, testing and developing nanomaterials for various industrial applications. And for all these innovations and services to reach the production sector that may lead to the creation of businesses, ITDI conducts knowledge translation or technology transfer program. ITDI actively engages the use of quad media, radio, television, print, online, social media, and exhibitions to promote its technologies and services. These are complemented with other technology transfer initiatives such as technology offerings, consultative meetings or industry engagements, TRA, trainings, all aimed at accelerating or increasing the chances for technology adoption, application. Through the years, we tirelessly contributed in laying the foundation for SDI in the country, ever committed to implement and achieve our mission. Remaining faithful to our core values. As we surge further into the future, ITDI solidly prepares an innovative ecosystem for new knowledge and technology to thrive. We are now aggressively pursuing the institutionalization of R&D initiatives and technical services that are attuned to current and emerging needs and help make us ready for Industry 4.0 or IR4. Indeed, from being a forerunner of science in the country, ITDI has emerged a trusted and competitive industry partner in accelerating national growth and development, driving local industries to be globally competitive and help make them ready for Industry 4.0, and ultimately, uplift the quality of life of every Filipino through science, technology, and innovation. We are ITDI. Our business is industry.
Okay, so thank you for watching our ABP. So kung meron po kayong pangailangan technical under our expertise such as food processing, chemicals and energy, environment and biotechnology, material science and packaging technology, and even training, technical assistance, at iba pa po. Na ito pong aming contact details, as you can see. You can address your inquiries, your letters to the Office of the Director under Dr. Annabel V. Briones. So makita po niyo po ang aming details. Or you can even directly send your email to ITDI Technological Service Division, which is shown din po yung aming details. So we have also our Facebook page, DOST-ITDI Update. So hanapin niyo lang po yan sa Facebook at makikita niyo po yung aming mga iba-ibang events and activities ng aming ahensya. Okay, so just a quick question lang po. May we know po your expectations for this webinar. So, can you key in your expectations dito po sa chat box? Can we see some expectations from you guys? Ano po yung in-expect nyo for this webinar po sa hand soap, liquid hand soap production? Mahihiyain ata ang ating mga participants, attendees sa ano ito ah. Okay, so from Miss Icineri, so ang gusto niya po dung talagang, in-expect niya to have a detailed formulation. Okay, from Sir Mar, learn a lot. Kay Mag Cherry, to learn how to make liquid hand soap. Okay, kay Kokong, sir, I will be able to make a hand washing soap. Si Sir Jerome, sources of materials, detailed processing, yes. Okay, kay Ma'am Rosalinda, learn how to make this product, yes ma'am. Kay Sir John Paulo Moreno, to start a new business from this, oh yes, yun po din ang aming gustong ma-attain nyo po. And then kay Ma'am Maricel, know where to acquire the ingredients, meron po tayo ding ipoprovide po sa ating mga viewers. From Ma'am Cindy, to learn the process of hand soap making. Ayan. It's good to know na talagang ating mga viewers, they want to start an enterprise about this. So we're expecting talaga din po na someday you will tell us na you have established an enterprise. Okay, so thank you sa mga send ang kanilang expectation. Okay, so everything daw gusto niyang malaman about hand soap kay Sir Charles. Okay, proper procedure with right formula kay Sir Azaril. Okay, basta pa tayo na ilan pa. Kay Sir CJ, I'm expecting to know how to make okay hand washing soap. Okay, so thank you po for the inputs of everyone. So that means I have a very proactive participants and talagang gusto niyo po talagang matuto dito sa webinar na to na sadyang ating yan ang ating purpose. Okay, so wag na po nating patagalin. Let me introduce our speakers for today. First is Miss Evelyn Manungsong. So, si Ma'am Evelyn po is a graduate of Bachelor of Science in Chemistry at the Philippine Normal University. She is currently a Senior Science Research Specialist of the Pharmaceutical Section ng ating CEB-ITDI. Siya po ay actually 30 years na in service dito po sa ITDI. She has attended a number of training here and abroad. So her field of expertise as a trainer are on personal and household care products, essential oil extraction, herbal processing, among others. So she is also involved in R&D projects of the said section. So our next speaker is Mr. Jan Ratsan Kyle de los Santos. So si Sir Kyle po is a science research analyst of the pharmaceutical section of CEB and a licensed chemist. He is also involved as trainer on personal and household care products, essential oil extraction, and involved in R&D projects. Okay, so that's our expert research speaker. So I think every one of you are already ready na. But before that, please note that the lectures are pre-recorded in order to manage the time well and have enough time for the question and answer of each presentation. So please listen carefully and pay attention po. And sana po, if possible, or kung ano po, mag-take notes din po kayo. And again, if you have questions, please put it in the chat box. At after the presentation, this will be answered by our experts. Okay, so I think okay na po ba ang lahat? Ready na? Thumbs up na po ba dyan? Kung merong marunong mag-thumbs up dyan, meron tayong ano dyan. So, I will call on now our resource speaker, Sir Kyle.
So good morning everyone who's watching the webinar po. So yun nga po, nabanggit po ni Ma'am Aleli kanina, we'll be learning about liquid hand soap production. So before we start, syempre kailangan po natin ng short introduction kung ano po ba ang liquid hand soap. So what is liquid hand soap? So it is formulated to wash and clean hands. So, syempre, soap siya. Ang purpose ng soap sa ating sa community natin is for cleaning. And for this specific purpose po natin ngayon sa webinar na ito, it's for cleaning of the hands or body parts po. So, it contains surfactants such as SLES, cocomide, DEA, cocobetaine, and other additives such as dye, fragrance, and humectants. So, ito po yung mga common na additives or ingredients na nagme-make up po nung liquid hand soaps po sa market ngayon. We'll discuss po in detail later yung for our basic formulation po na ipaprovide dito. Makikita nyo po ano yung mga specific na ginamit po namin. Lastly, yung iba't ibang product variations ng liquid hand soap may include for, kasi minsan po pagka mga for toddlers po yung application or for sensitive skins, may mga iniiba po sila. So, such as those with mild formulations or children with antibacterial properties, natural formulations, nakadepende po yung ingredients, yung process, kung ano po yung parang magiging set goal po natin or set consumer target po. So here are the ingredients po na gagamitin natin for this basic formulation. So we'll be using 832 grams of distilled water, or deionized water, whichever po yung available sa inyo. And next, we'll be using 100 grams of sodium lauryl ether sulfate or SLES. We'll be using 40 grams of cocoa diethanolamide or CDEA. Next, we'll be using 10 grams of cocomidopropylbutane or cocobutane. Yung common name po niya is cocobutane sa market po. Next, 15 grams of sodium chloride or salt. We prefer yung technical grade po na salt. Then, 1 gram of phenoxyethanol, 1 gram of propylene glycol, 1 gram of set, and colorant po na pwede naman ano siya, more on optional use po or kung hanggang masatisfy po kayo sa itsura ng product po. So ito po yung mga itsura ng mga ingredients. If mag-search po kayo online, ito po yung common na itsura nila. So you can just review later po pagka gusto nyo pong balikan, available naman po itong video na to. So see po yung mga iba't ibang products. Madali rin naman po siyang i-search online po. So, ayan po. Tools and equipment needed. So, usually we would need mixing container or bowl or kung ano man pong basin yung available sa inyo. Nabasa po, kakasya po yung capacity natin. For this formulation po na gagawin natin today, yung papakita po namin demonstration, it will be producing 1 liter of hand soap. So if gagaya ano po, if you will do the procedure as is, make sure po yung mixing container po or yung basin po natin is will be enough para makover po yung 1 liter no hand soap. Next, we'll need wide mouth containers or any available na containers po na meron for the ingredients po para po separated sila, hindi po sila mag-mix. Weighing scale, importante po yung weighing scale kasi for accurate measurements po para walang masayang or walang sumobra dun sa mga ingredients po natin sa paggamit. pH paper po, we'll be using that to check po yung pH ng final formulation to make sure na nasa inline po tayo dun sa recommended pH na 7 po kasi pagka below or above po ng pH na 7 baka po kasi mag-cause po ng mga skin irritation, ganun po, or any other problems po. So, kailangan po ng pH paper to test po yun. Funnels, spatulas, and plastic ladle po, useful po makuha yan. Pati po yung steering rod, useful po yung mga yan for the mixing and yung transfers po ng mga ingredients po. Droppers for the smaller liquids po kasi if needed po na mga small amounts lang, pwede nyo pong gamitan ng droppers para po hindi po sobra-sobra yung pag-weigh, ganun po. And especially, yung packaging containers. So, iba-iba po itsura ng packaging containers sa market na depende rin po sa inyo yun kung anong sizes po yung, kunyari po, if mag-start po kayo ng business, kung anong size po yung mga product nyo, readily available naman po sa market yan. Or if nasa line po kayo na paggawa ng packaging, pwede nyo pong i-customize yun as you see fit po dun sa inyong product po. So, functions of the ingredients. So, importante rin po na alam natin yung functions ng ingredients na gagamitin natin dito sa formulation na to para po may idea po sa safety and at the same time, alam lang po natin kung para saan nga yung hinahalo natin kasi syempre hindi naman po maganda na halo lang tayo nakahalo ng hindi natin alam. So, syempre, distilled water, it's the formulation solvent, and the purity of the water used prolongs the product shelf life. So, we recommend distilled water or deionized water if mas available po, mas maganda po sana ng deionized water if ayun ang available sa inyo, or any other types of water na mataas yung purity, kasi it will help po enhance yung product nyo. Kaysa po kung tap water gagamitin natin kasi pag tap water, madami pong contaminants yun. Yun po yung iniiwasan natin. Mas madaming contaminants present doon sa formulation, mas mali-degrade siya agad. So, bababa po yung shelf life niya. So, the next ingredient is sodium lauryl ether sulfate or SLES. It is the main surfactant or surface active agent with good detergency and foamability present in common cleaning materials. So, if mapapansin nyo sa market, ito yung isa sa mga pinaka-common na nakalista po doon sa product list nila. Ang purpose po kasi ni SLES is the main, siya po yung nag-serve as the main surfactant natin. And yung surfactant po kasi, sila yung surface active agent niya na nagkakos ng cleaning po property, nagbibigay ng cleaning property ng formulation. So yung SLES po has a paste-like appearance. So pag bumili po kayo nito, pag nag-search po kayo, makikita niyo po para siyang paste. And one thing to note po is yung SLES po, according to the ano po safety data sheet po ng chemical na yan, ay meron siyang corrosive and irritant warning. So it can cause skin irritation, severe eye damage, and severe eye irritation upon long exposures po. So importante po, pamaya po, makikita niyo po habang sa demonstration na dapat po naka-PPE tayo, naka-gloves, naka-safety apron or gown, ganun po, and goggles para po hindi po tayo ma-expose directly do sa chemicals. Although, hindi naman po siya ganun ka-dangerous talaga, it's better to be safe po, syempre. Next is yung po diethanolamide or CDEA. So it is ang purpose po ni CDEA dito sa formulation is the co-surfactant and foam booster. So ano po ba ang purpose ng co-surfactant? Mostly ano lang po siya. It just gives more enhances yung purpose ng main surfactant natin by providing good thickening and wetting properties. In this case po si CDEA, more on the foaming po siya. Kasi syempre yung sabon po natin mas usually sa mga mata ng tao, mas ma-foam po, mas nakakalinis, although it's not really the case, pero maganda rin po kasi na may, ano po, maganda yung pag-foam niya po para bumubula po talaga siya. So yung sisidaya po natin dito sa case po ng formulation na to is it helps the main surfactant po for the cleaning properties. At the same time, nagpo-provide siya ng magandang foaming ability po. So one thing to note po sa kanya, sa safety warning po is irritant rin po siya. So it can cause, CDEA can cause skin irritation and severe eye damage, irritation in prolonged exposures po pagka na direct contact po doon. Next is the cocobidopropyl betaine or cocobetaine. So it is a medium strength surfactant and ano rin po siya, co-surfactant rin po siya dito sa ating formulation. It reduces irritation and serves as a foam booster. So medium strength surfactant siya, kaya ganun po yung description kasi po nakakatulong po siya to inya po reduces irritation or yung ano po yung pagka happy nung formulation sa katawan kasi syempre po sabon po dapat siya ginagamit natin sa kamay, so dapat po hindi tayo ma-irritate, ganun po. Ang purpose po niya is para bumaba po yung ganun pong feeling doon sa soap na nagagawin natin. At ano po, one warning lang po sa kanya is irritant rin po siya and it can cause skin irritation and severe eye irritation rin po at prolonged exposures po, direct exposure. So iwasan po natin yan. Next is sodium chloride or salt. Familiar naman po lahat tayo sa salt. So, pero yung purpose po niya sa ating formulation is thickener po, thickener agent. So, gagamitin, makikita niyo po mamaya na yung salt in solution po, it will cause the yung pagkalapot po ng ating liquid hand soap po. So white crystalline powder in appearance, alam naman po natin itsura ng salt po and madali po itong ma-purchase po ito sa market. So one warning is consider din po siyang irritant and it can cause serious eye damage or irritation upon direct exposure po or direct contact. Kaya nga po, pag nagsiswimming tayo sa tubig dagat, di ba po, mahabdi sa mata po dahil po sa salt po yun. So, the next ingredient po is yung phenoxyethanol. It serves as a preservative. So, appears as a colorless liquid with a pleasant smell that acts as a fixative and antiseptic. So, ang purpose po ni phenoxyethanol is to maintain po yung pagkalinis or yung purity ng product natin. Preservative po siya in the sense na iniiwasan po yung formation ng mga molds, ganun po, or any other microbial buildup po dun sa formulation natin. Phenoxyethanol, however, mag-isa is also considered an irritant and it can cause serious eye irritation and harmful when swallowed. So, iwasan po natin ito. Recommended po rin na wag po natin gawin yung formulation around children, ganun po, para po maiwasan yung mga swallowing of chemicals po kasi masama po talaga. So the next one is yung propylene glycol. It is the humectant or moisturizing agent, and it appears as a viscous colorless liquid. So propylene glycol po kasi, or any glycols na chemicals po, is more on nag-absorb po kasi sila ng moisture from the air, from surfaces po. So yun po yung nagbibigay ng moisturizing property ng ating soap po. And lastly, yung scent and colorant, for aesthetic purposes lang po sila. So it increases appeal and marketability of the product, pero wala po silang effect dun sa mismong cleaning ability ng soap po natin. More on appearance lang po talaga sila. So makikita niyo po, although nagbigay kami kanina ng weight for the scent po, hindi naman po kailangan sundan yun. Kasi for example, yung scent na ginagamit po natin, natural or synthetic scent pa yan, ay kulang po yung amoy. Hindi nyo po naaamoy masyado. Parang kulang, nakukulangan po kayo dun sa for, ano, sa nilagay nyo po. Pwede nyo po siyang dagdagan. Parang ano naman po siya, as you see fit po. Pati po sa color, kasi baka mamaya nag-drop na kayo ng color pero hindi pa kayo satisfied. Pwede nyo po siyang dagdagan or bawa, ano po, or kayo po yung magkocontrol ng paglagay po nun, as you see fit po dun sa specifications po na gusto nyo doon sa product nyo po, sa goal nyo po. So with that, before we proceed po doon sa procedure part, so always remember safety first po, like I said po kanina, kung kaya po, maintain po natin yung working area po natin na malinis para to avoid spills, to avoid yung mga matatabig, ganun po. Hanggang kaya po sana, sa laboratory po tayo mag-work, or if kayo sa home lang po kayo gagawa, somewhere open po with proper ventilation po. Wear safety goggles, safety gown or aprons and gloves po. Importante yun. Para po maiwasan natin yung mga pagangati, ganun po, or any other injury po na pwede mangyari during the formulation part po. So, for the procedure, so, for step one, weigh all ingredients in separate containers with labels. So, makikita niyo po sa video, winaweigh po isa-isa yung mga product. And maganda po sana, nag-label po natin yun para po maiwasan natin yung mixing or pagkakamali ng salin po during the formulation proper na po. Magandang dapat may label po palagi para hindi po tayo nalilito. Lalo na po yung mga liquid, ano natin, yung mga liquid na chemicals po natin, usually mukhang tubig lang talaga yung iba doon. Kaya maganda po na separate po natin sila with individual labels po. Kung ano po yung available na mga lalagyan sa inyo, yun po yung pwede nyo gamitin. So nakita nyo po sa case ng video namin, dahil sa laboratory po kami gumawa, ang ginamit po namin is mga beakers po and mga open mouth na containers po. Since yun po yung readily available sa amin. Next is to dissolve 15 grams of sodium chloride in 100 ml deionized water. So, dito po, i-ready natin yung ating sodium chloride solution to add later po. So, after make sure po na ano po siya, fully dissolved po, then set aside muna kasi mamaya pa po talaga siya gagamitin. Use adequate stirring po para ma-make sure na lahat po ng solid particles ni sodium chloride or ni salt po ay fully dissolved po dun sa solution. Next is to add 40 ml sidea, 10 ml cocoa betaine, and 1 ml propylene glycol to SDS with stirring. So, nakita niyo po sa video, meron po kami mas malaking container na ginamit kasi doon po namin, yun po yung magiging final lalagyan po namin ng formulation before po i-transfer sa bottle or yung pinaka-final container po niya. So, mix lang po lahat doon, yung nabanggit po, 40 ml sidea for 10 40 ml or 40 grams sidea, 10 ml cocoa betaine, 1 ml or 1 gram propylene glycol to SLS po. So pagkahaluin po sila lahat doon sa container. Okay, so yun po. The next step is to add the sodium chloride solution to the mixture. Ito pa yung prepare nating sodium chloride kanina. So, i-add po natin siya with stirring. Makita nyo po na nagsastart na siyang bumula. Nagbubula po kasi talaga since naghalo na po tayo ng mga surfactants po. Masastart po siyang mag-bubbles po talaga. So, hanggang kaya pong sa pag-mix po sana natin, paunti-unti lang po, huwag masyadong mabilis. Yung tama lang, para maiwasan po yung build-up talaga ng soap. If ever po pala na meron kayong mga mechanical stirrer or electronic stirrer mixer po sa bahay, pwede nyo pong gamitin yun, pero yun nga po, be aware po na once mabilis po yung stirring kasi talaga, magbabubble up po siya. And yung mga bubbles po, hanggang kaya, wag po natin itapon since meron pa rin pong presence ng soap po dun sa mga particles na po. Oh, I forgot to mention po dun sa isang sa previous step po dito sa step 3. Ito po, sa step 3 na to, i-add na rin po natin yung ibang water na natira po. Kasi di ba kung mamamit po tayo 100 grams of water kanina for the sodium chloride, after mixing po yung SLS with the 40 grams a day or 10 grams cocoa butane and 1 gram propylene glycol, mix na rin po natin yung water na natira po dito. So we would proceed to the next step po. So the next step is to add colorant and essence and mix well until uniform. So makikita niyo po sa video, nag-add po kami ng ilang drops ng food color. To make it red, kasi red po yung napili namin color during the demonstration. Tapos po, like we said po kanina, although nagbigay kami ng weight doon sa, nagbigay kami specific weight doon sa table before, kanina, ng ingredient list for the scent, it's up to you. Kung, kasi depende, may ibang scent kasi na malakas yung amoy, may ibang scent na hindi ganun katapang, ano. So nakadepende po sa inyo if dadagdagan nyo pa hanggang masatisfy na po kayo sa amoy saka sa visual po. So mimix po ng maigi yan and ililet pong subside yung mga bubbles later. So ayan po, adjust to pH 6 to 7 using 50% citric acid solution. So in case po, usually po kasi may tendency siya na matingin mataas yung pH. Usually ang pH na lumalabas after mixing everything po nasa ano siya, nasa pH 8. If ever po ganun yung lumabas, you can use 50% citric acid solution para po bumaba yung pH niya. Ilang drops lang po yun. As you can verify po using pH paper po para makita kung pH 7 na po siya. 50% citric acid po naman kasi is safe naman po yun. It's food safe po. So, tinitimpla po yun. You just add, pag 50% is just add 1:1 po, citric acid to water po. And yun po yung magiging 50% citric acid solution nyo po. So, set aside and allow bubbles to subside. So, makikita nyo po dito sa picture, wala na po yung bubbles before do sa mga video after po mag-subside siya. So, nag-subside, inilet namin siya to, left namin siya to subside around 15 to 30 minutes po hanggang nawala yung bubbles. So, importante po huwag natin tapon yung bubbles kasi sayang, meron nga po, nagko-contain pa rin po kasi yung soap na formulation po. So, pagka tinapon po kasi natin yung mga bubbles, mangyayari, makikita nyo po mamaya, nabawasan, imbis na parang 1 liter talaga yung nagawa natin, nababawasan siya. So, hanggang kaya po, maintain nyo po siya, then just let it air out po. Kasi kusa naman magpa-pop yung mga bubbles na yun over time. So the next step is to pack or to place it in plastic containers with labels. So ito na po yung paglipat natin do sa container. So ang example namin dito was using 250 ml plastic container po na with pump po yung cover niya for liquid soaps po. Readily available rin po kasi sa market yung mga ganyang plastic container, or like I said before, if meron po kayo specific branding or specific na gustong maging itsura ng appearance ng inyong soap, nasa sa inyo po yun kung paano nyo po siya i-market po kasi. So, basta po, nasa sa inyo rin po yung kung ano yung magiging final packaging ng product po. So, ito po yung finished product nung sa demonstration. Ito po yung naging itsura nung sa amin po. So, ito po, business opportunity plan. So, following po yung estimates na mga nakuha namin, this is just an estimation po. For example po, na gumawa po tayo ng 40 pieces of 250 ml bottles per per day. Ganun po. Naka 40 bottles tayo ng 250 ml bottles tayo. Ang mga gastos po natin is around ang mga ang magiging parang total ano po, total cost is around 1,200 po. And unit cost is 30 pesos per bottle po. So pwede po natin i-mark up 'yon to sell it around 36, and ang balik po natin doon ay ang return of investment po natin is around 91% with a payback period in 1.1 na years. So malaki-laki po yung tubo natin dito po sa hard soap formulation po na ito. Pero reminder lang po na ito po estimations at ano po, hindi natin po alam kung nagbago na po yung prices since medyo in demand po ngayon itong mga products na ito for the production nga po ng soap since may pandemic po tayong ongoing. Pero at the same time, malaking ano rin po to, malaking opportunity rin po to jump into sa trends. Kasi nga po, dahil pandemic period po tayo ngayon, in demand po talaga yung soap. So maganda rin po to jump in sa business na ito habang malaki po yung ano demand talaga doon sa product po. So list of suppliers. So ito pong mga nasa screen nyo ngayon ay yung mga suppliers na easily accessible po around NCR area po. So Atkinson, Sefina Mega Sales, Allison's Chemicals, Fragrance World, and Best Pack. Ano po to? Halos lahat po ng nasa screen nyo po ay pwede pong walk-in. Walk-in ang purchases. Or pwede nyo po silang, yung iba po sa kanila, nagpatanggap rin ng orders na for delivery. Si Atkinson's and Allison's Chemicals, however, more on bulk, ano po sila, bulk orders po. Kung yung malalaking capacity orders like 10 liters of ganito, 10 grams of 10 kilos of ganun. So, if mga more on ano lang kayo, home base yung maliit ang production muna, pwede na po yung sa Fragrance World or sa Best Pack po. Pero kung nagbabalak po kayo talaga ng malaki after mo matest na po yung product nyo po, you can contact po yung mga malalaking chemical suppliers po. Tapos for those na hindi po tuma-access ito pong list of suppliers, these are just suggestions lang naman po kasi yung chemicals naman po na pinesent namin are all common. So madali po siyang makita online kung saan po pwede makabili sa pinakamalapit pong supplier na accessible po sa inyo. If nasa probinsya po kayo, most likely po may nagsusupply po ng mga chemicals na yan. Since so very common lang po talaga yung mga chemicals na dinisplay po namin kanina. So with that po, ito po yung mga contact details po na pwede nyo tawagan. If meron po kayong mga any inquiries or any interest po sa mga technology po namin. So with that po, thank you po sa pakikinig po sa presentation.
We will proceed na with our Q&A. And meron po tayong mga nauna ng questions during yung discussion po. Let me pull out lang po. Okay, galing po ito kay Sir Aaron Joseph. Ano daw po ang difference ng deionized water at distilled water aside from the price? Sir?
Okay po. So, distilled water po kasi is more on water for drinking. Pure water po siya na ginagamit po natin for drinking purposes po. Malinis na siya. Pero yung deionized water po kasi, it's not for drinking. It's a type of water na wala pong mga halong any ions, any minerals po. So it's not meant for drinking po. It's mostly used po for cosmetic purposes po or for mga formulation po like this ones po. Nakikita niyo po sa yung pinakita nga po namin. So yun po yung difference nila. In terms of purity po, mas pure po ang deionized water although mas mahal po siya konti.
Okay, thank you for that, Sir Kyle. Next question po natin is from Team Garbozas. Ano po ang mangyayari if tap water po ang gagamitin? Pwede po ba yun?
So, actually, pwede naman po talaga natin gamitin si tap water. Pero po kasi, if balak niyo po siyang ibenta or for market, gagawa po kayo ng business, then you'll be using tap water po as the solvent po. Baka po magka-problema po tayo when it comes to the shelf life po and yung purity po ng product natin. Lalo na po, I think may mga rules po ang FDA regarding po ano po mga parang specific na dapat gamitin po. Kasi pagka tap water po kasi madaming halo po yun. May mga chlorine po yun, may mga minerals and ions po. Madami pong nakahalo doon na hindi natin alam. So it may contaminate po yung formulation natin. So we don't really recommend that. At maganda po talaga ang gagamitin natin is either distilled water or deionized water or something on par po sa purity na yun. Ganun po.
Okay. Next question po. What is an alternative po sa estless?
Yung estless kasi, yan yung lagi namin ginagamit. So ngayon, hindi pa kami nag-try ng ibang chemicals for estless. Although, ito kasi yung mga yung main surfactants.
Okay po. So, to add on po dun, since sa formulation po namin kasi is a basic, it's very basic formulation lang po talaga, pero pwede naman po talagang palitan si estless as the main surfactant po. Marami pong available na surfactant sa market po. Depende sa needs. Meron pa nga po mga specific surfactants na ginagamit for mga baby soaps po na mas milder, ganun po, like yung mga glucoside surfactants po. Ginagamit po yun sa mga ano po, sa mga baby formulations, sa mga shampoos, ganun, baby soaps, kasi they have milder effects, milder effects sa balat, ganun po. So, for the sake lang po ng ating formulation, we use estless po, yun po yung na-test namin since yun po yung parang basic lang po ito. Pero once na nakuha nyo na po kasi itong formulation na ito, pwede nyo po siyang i-modify how you see it. Pwede nyo pong, depende nga po kung ano yung goal po ninyo for the production, kung anong balak nyo pong gawin sa kanya, pwede nyo po siyang readily i-modify. You can follow the weights exactly, pwede nyo rin pong baguhin. It's up to you na po yun.
So, a question from Ma'am Annalyn Bontilao. pH lang po ba ang quality test needed for skin irritation?
Yung pH kasi measurement yun kung yung acidity and basicity ng product mo. Ngayon, since na it is readily available, yung pH, yun ang ginagamit namin for detection ng pH ng product namin.
Okay. So, ano naman po, regarding testing po kasi, si pH po yung pinakamadaling gawing test po to ensure lang po na safe si product na nun. Pero po, if ever po kasi, kunyari, nag-deviate nga po kayo doon sa formulation na pinabite namin, nagpalit kayo ng certain compounds or certain chemicals, ganun po, may mga sinubstitute po kayo during your own formulation po, kumbaga, ganun po. May mga testing po talaga nire-require usually po sa mga testing laboratories po, pwede nyo pong patry, pagawa po sa kanila para po makita if safe po talaga yung product nyo po. Pero for this case po kasi, dahil basic formulation lang po yung shinay namin, and dahil alam naman na po namin na ito is safe and sure na gagana po, ang pinakita lang po namin sa inyo, yung test for pH po, to ensure lang na tama yung pH levels po niya. Pero po, na-test naman na po ito sa iba't ibang ano po, properties rin po.
Okay, so again, here are our contact details. Again, you can send your inquiries, your questions, your clarifications sa ating pong ITDI Technological Services Division. And you can directly inquire sa ITDI Chemicals and Energy Division. So, we are just asking po na for those na nakapag-establish ng ating small business, sana po ma-inform nyo po kami or ma-email nyo po kami on kung kayo po ay nakapag-establish ng isang negosyo about this liquid hand soap. And gusto rin po namin malaman nyo na after this webinar, hindi ito po ang end ng ating communication, ng aming assistance sa inyo. You can always contact us, you can always email us regarding sa mga assistance po na kailangan nyo. And we are willing to provide po support through consultancy po. So again, kami po ay magagala kung kayo po ay mag-inform sa amin about how did you go about dito sa ating webinar na ito. So, before we end po, we just want to thank our trainers, ang ating resource speakers, si Ma'am Evelyn, si Sir Kyle, for your efforts and cooperation, and the staff po ng pharmaceutical section. Sa head po o IC po ng Chemicals and Energy Division, si Engineer Apollo Bawagan. Salamat po, sir, for your support and commitment. Sa RCTS team po, kay Ms. Karen, kay Sir Mark, kay Ms. Nam, salamat po sa iyong assistance. Salamat po sa inyo lahat and sana po makita po uli namin kayo sa aming future webinars.